must have a code that you can live by, and so become yourself, because the past is just a goodbye. Teach your children well, their father's hell will slowly go by, and feed them on your dreams, the ones they picks, the ones you know by. Don't you ever ask them why, if they told you you would cry, so just look at them and
Good morning, and welcome on this third Sunday of Lent. It's great to be together. Special welcome to John Cohen, who's with us this morning to sing along with the gang. We're grateful for John's presence. Bless the Lord who forgives all of our sins. God's mercy endures forever. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, you know that we have no power in ourselves to help ourselves. Keep us both outwardly in our bodies and inwardly in our souls, that we may be defended from all adversities which may happen to the body, and from all evil thoughts which may assault and hurt the soul. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The statutes of the Lord rejoice the heart. The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament shows his handiwork. One day till it takes another, and when night imports knowledge to another. Although they have no words or language, and their voices are not heard, their sound has gone out into all the land, and their message to the ends of the world. In the deep has he set a pavilion for the sun. It comes forth like the bridegroom out of his chamber. It rejoices like a champion to run its course. It goes forth from the utmost edge of the heavens and runs about to the end of it again. Nothing is hidden from its burning heat. The law of the Lord is perfect and revives the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure and gives wisdom to the innocent. Who can tell how often be he offends? Cleanse me from my secret faults. Above all, keep your servant from the presumptuous sins. Let them not get dominion over me. Then shall I be whole and sound and innocent of a great offense. Let the wounds of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my Redeemer.
I invite you to stand for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, Lord Christ. The Passover of the Jews was near, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple he found people selling cattle, sheep, and doves, and the money changers seated at their tables. Making a whip of cords, Jesus drove all of them out of the temple, both the sheep and the cattle. He also poured out the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. He told those who were selling their doves, "Take these things out of here. Stop making my Father's house a marketplace." His disciples remembered that it was written, "Zeal for your house will consume me." The Jews then said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews then said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you'll raise it up in 3 days? But Jesus was speaking of the temple of his body. After he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the word that Jesus had spoken. The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ.
It is fun having John Cowan here with us this morning, and always to hear the beautiful musicians that we have, and hear Dave Ragland's take on that psalm was stunning. And I just want to say, to be very, very honest as I'm starting this, that I'm not above selling stuff in the church. Y'all know that about me, so I feel a little bit weird preaching on this gospel because I love the church being a marketplace. Actually, what I love is I love that the church goes out to the marketplace, that we're not insulated, and that we're not afraid to engage the world in the issues of justice. It's good to know what hashtag Love Heals goes for in a marketplace and what it will bear and how it influences the changes. Also, I'm not opposed to sweeping things under the rug. You know, and that sometimes serves a purpose. Especially if you have 3 dogs and kids and you're in a house, it's like sometimes you have to just function. But what this gospel really is about is taking that stuff, overturning the tables. It's taking that stuff of when we commercialize and ritualize somehow our worship, that it's time to turn those tables over, to dig deeper into the truth, to reveal what it is we want to teach about our faith to the world and to one another and to the children. And what Jesus reminds us is sometimes when we do that, when we go through the process of going ahead and turning over the tables to dig to that deeper truth, that there is a lot of messiness, there's a lot of anger, there's a lot of fear, and intimacy, all of those things. When we really want to dig into the deeper truth, when you and I want to turn over those tables that have been so perfectly set and set that way for a reason. It's really hard. This week is the anniversary of so much in our beautiful community, in our beautiful world. When you think about a year ago, it was the tornadoes. And all of us, do y'all remember? We were all called to go out and help clean up. And then immediately it was like, don't go out. There's a pandemic. Come home. And there was that whole journey of everybody. It was Kathy Fell and Charlie Strobel Street that got hit so hard. And we all wanted to be out there with them and dig through that rubble with them. And that seems like it set the tone for the whole year. Of all the tables getting turned over and all those things that we had, like there was dispensations and ways that we kept things smooth. Just get two doves, don't look any deeper, you're gonna be fine. That we really had to start grappling with it. And what's more powerful in this gospel than anything for me is Jesus is not just saying, I'm upending these tables, I'm asking you to dig through all the mess and the rubble together. He's saying, I'll help you with the gift of my own life, my body. That I know that doing that work for anyone who wants to dig deeper into the truth, that it's costly and we pay for it in our very lives, in our time, talent, and treasures. What I've learned this year is truth is not the same as fact. Haven't y'all learned that really well again? We've learned that lesson once again. That we can all get the same set of facts and we can all dig deeper and find what our truth is and how it speaks to us. And that is very costly and messy and it's angry and it is really, really hard. And this gospel saying, don't rest on the idea that you've set your table, you've made your truth, and you never have to overturn it again and you never have to dig deeper. It's for all of us. The deepest truth lies within, and you know because it moves beneath your head and it wends your way into your heart. I've heard so much truth from the community I get to sit in here and at Thistle Farms in that circle every daggum week. And this week, I was learning from a woman named Lee who's celebrating 2 years clean. You know, she is somebody who tells the story, and it's, again, it's just an awful story. We've heard it many, many times, but just like there is a soldier story and then the story of the soldier, her soldier story includes being kidnapped in Memphis and her captor shaving her head off, shaving all her hair off and keeping her in a back room, and her whispering to one of her Johns, when you get out of here, please call 911. She couldn't get out. They raided the place, and the police officers gave her a bus ticket and said, you need to make better choices. So she gets on a Greyhound bus with a shaved head and comes to Nashville and continues a horrific story and journey. And what she said to mark her 2-year anniversary of digging for deeper truth, of overturning every table in her life that she has known, is this. You say love heals. And that seems impossible to me, but what I've learned is that if I can trust, I am opening the door to love. I was like, that's so truly that the biggest, bravest thing is to trust each other enough to allow love to do its healing work. I'm so glad I can still learn the lessons and think, you know, I have still so much to learn. It's not like trying to say, I love you, I love you, I love you, but that I can live my life saying, I'm worthy to be trusted by you. That's a powerful truth. Jesus in this gospel is reminding us that faith is not the same as belief, and that the strongest faith thrives in unrequited hearts still searching and willing to dig deeper. We move past our fear. And somehow, even in that rubble and those unturned tables, there's some kind of hope and freedom. That's radical. And he reminds us that wisdom is not the same as knowledge. The greatest wisdom is birthed from truth and faith. And it's raised on crumbs from little gospel stories like this, from past pilgrims who scattered those truths along the way, from kind teachers like Lee and the myriad of people who have gained such truth. All of us, we can hope that someday we turn over enough tables that we gain such wisdom, that we know our truth and we feel comfortable in our faith. My prayer for this year on this anniversary is you and I don't have to keep pivoting like ballerinas forever. But sometimes it's nice to upend things and dig through the remnants and rubbles. That you and I aren't searching for quick and easy answers. We're willing to dig through and sift through things to find our truth and our faith. Keep digging for the truth. Keep learning the lessons and keep allowing them to form us into what love is. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you. It is great to have a live audience here today. If you would like to be here. Congregation, yes. If you would like to be part of the live congregation in the weeks ahead, we would love to have you. We all wear masks and we're socially distanced. Just send an email to Susan, and we would love to see you here if you would like to come. If there's anything that you need, if you need prayers or food or would like for one of us to bring the Eucharist to you, please let us know. We are here for you, and we are keep you in our prayers. We're so grateful to be in this together. Thank you for all the ways that you give. If you would like to give via Venmo or a check or however you might choose to do that, there's information here that Matt will show here on the screen. And last but not least, this morning at 10:15, we'll have our third adult forum led by Francisco, and called Healing Resistance. So the information is on the website about how to connect via Zoom. It's also, I believe, on the live stream page. So I hope that you will join us for that. Let us walk in love as Christ has loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Our good friend John Cowan with us today. Pardon.
me to the alley. Take me to the addicted ones. Take me to the lonely ones that somehow lost their way. Let us hear him say, he is our friend. We'll sit at his table and rest here in his garden. We will have a pardon. Yes, we will have a pardon. Yes, we will have a pardon. We will have a pardon.
Gracious and loving God, we give you thanks for all the gifts of creation. We give you thanks for this bread and the wine, the work of human hands. We give you thanks for the forgiveness of our sins as we forgive others. We pray for all the leaders of the nations that they hear the cries of the poor. We pray for gratitude. Dig deeper into all the mercy we have ever known and to offer it with compassion for the whole world. We pray for all those who suffer in body, mind, and spirit, especially Tolu, Mark, Betty Lou, Kay, Russ, Ryan, Evan, Terry, who is on death row, and all those we love in prison and in jails. We pray for all those who mourn, especially Diane Bishop as she grieves the loss of her mom, Gloria, and Sarah Glover as she grieves the loss of her mom, Sarah Little. We give you thanks for CCJ, the Holy Cross Hospice, the Escuela and Stevens Larkspur Thistle Farms, NFP, and all the ministries we are blessed to serve. Especially this week, we thank you for the Front Porch Pantry, and all the families within this chapel and within our wider community that we have been able to serve. Thank you for all the saints who continue to teach us to walk with humility and courage, that in the rubble, after we turn over the tables, we shall find love. Above all, we give you thanks that on the night before you were handed over to suffering and death, you gathered your disciples around the table and took bread and broke it and gave it to them and said, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. And after supper, you took the cup of wine, and when you given thanks, you gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. And sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this Holy Communion and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints, especially Magdalene and Augustine and Eduardo, into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory are yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. And as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. The gifts of God for the people of God. Here, do you want to get one as you come up and teach everyone else? That way you can teach them.
Lives were mine to love and cherish, to guard and guide along life's way. Oh God, forbid that one should perish, that one alas should go astray.
beautiful. Thank you. Let us pray. Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Creator, Redeemer, and the Comforter, be with you today and always. Amen.
Thank you for the gospel half hour. Brought
to you by Bunny Bread.
Yes, Wonder Bread.
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. May you stay.
In peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Oh, it's a lamb.